Good morning, students. I hope you all are fit and fine. So today I am going to explain you that experiment that Mandel conducted on the pea plant. So as you all know that Mandel was an Austrian monk, and he conducted several hybridization experiment on the garden pea. Scientific name of pea is Picum sativum, which has become, all his experiments has become a milestone in the biology. Now why he selected garden pea only? So here are three reasons. First one is that pea comes in many varieties. So many varieties were available in alternate forms. Alternate forms means pea plant, we can get the pea plant height wise, tall also, dwarf also, color wise. Pea plant produce the white flower, purple flower. Their pea pod color has two color, and even the size or shape of the pea seed is round and wrinkled. So I will, as you can see in this picture, based on the characters, there are two alternative characters of flower color, seed shape, pod color, pod shape, flower position, auxiliary when it is at the axis of the leaf or over the leaf, and terminal when the flower is behind the leaf. Plant height, tall and dwarf. So based on every character has the two alleles. This one, earlier one, all are the dominant as it is written here, all are the super ruling, and other is the recessive. So based on this finding, this Mandel selected the garden pea. Next one is, varieties were available in the pure form. There is no intermediate, interbreed is there, an intermediate character is there. So the tall character will pass on to the next generation. So it will produce the same type of generation after generation, if that particular gene will pass, then only. So varieties were available in the pure form. Then one of the main reason is that pea plant is self-pollinated plant. So it contain both male and female androecium and gynoecium part. So it can pollinate itself selfly. They do not need any agents. It do not require any agent. Next is that we can do the cross-pollinated also. We can make it artificially also. We can by removing the corresponding stamen or pistil of the plant, androecium and gynoecium of the plant, we can make the flower artificially pollinated. So this is a very important point, that it is a self-pollinated naturally, but we can make it artificial cross-pollinated also by removing male gamete or female gamete, anyone. So that's why there are three reasons. Now Mandel crossed pure breeding varieties. So he has conducted two crosses. So first cross is called monohybrid cross, and then in which he has taken and he used only one feature, one character. And next cross is the dihybrid, with in which he has used two characters. So how he performed it and what observation he found, let's see. So here you can see, I have already explained you about this diagram. So you can see it is a beautiful colorful diagram. Now so in a monohybrid cross he used, so there are three cases. So in the one case that he used terminal flower and auxiliary flower, then second last you can see flower position. Based on the flower position we have the terminal flower. So he used this character of terminal flower, and he crossed with the pure breeding which is having auxiliary flower. Between the two, you know that this here all are the dominant character and the second one all are the recessive trait, recessive character. So in this auxiliary and terminal, auxiliary is the dominant gene, alle, which super rule the terminal one. So whenever the cross will occur or takes place in between the terminal and auxiliary, auxiliary flower will rule always. Remember this, because this is the dominant trait. Now what will be the resulting? So the resulting seed after sowing, we have to sow the seeds into the ground only, into the soil only. So when we, after sowing, they will produce axial flower only in the F1 generation. I have explained you in that Zoom class also, that in the F1 generation all the seeds will be auxiliary, because auxiliary is the dominant trait between the two. And but in the F2 generation, which is also called as filial generation. So please, this F1, what is F1, what is F2, this is first filial generation. And filial generation means a cross between the offspring, so it is representing the offsprings. Okay, so we can cross F1 generation, and if we will cross the F1 generation again, then we will get the F2 generation, and again from the F2 we will get the F3 generation. Like this we can get by the hybridization method. So here you can see diagram is given 3.7. so when terminal flower, which is denoted by small AA, because all the alleles we have to write in a pairs, it occurs in a pairs, so we have to write small AA two times in a pair only. Auxiliary flower, it is a dominant, so we are writing here in a capital letter. So remember that we have to denote the dominant trait with capital letter and the recessive with the small letter, so we can easily understand this. Now, so we, in the F1 generation, we will take the one A, single A, and one small A. So when it will be cross, okay, with Punnett square, we will also get all the, in the F1 generation, we will get all the auxiliary flower, which is heterozygous, and they all are auxiliary because they contain a dominant gene, capital A, which super rule this terminal one. Same as if the all these F1 generation hybrid, if they will again do the hybridization, or when we will provide them that self-pollination, when they will do the self-pollination, they will produce all the this F2 generation, they will produce all the offsprings or plant into the 3:1 ratio. I told you, genotypically it is 3:1, and phenotypically it is 1:2, 2:1. Because why one? Because this first one is the purely dominant, these two are the heterozygous, and this last one, it is purely recessive trait. So 1:2, 2:1. Or we can say that 3:1, because 3:1 means all three are the auxiliary flower. You can see all are having the capital A, whereas the last one is the purely terminal. So in the monohybrid ratio, the phenotypic ratio, which we can see, will be 3:1, 3 auxiliary and 1 terminal, and the genotypically it is 1:2, 2:1. This one is homozygous, these two are heterozygous, and this last one is also homozygous. So in the exam you should remember that monohybrid ratio, always phenotypic ratio will be 3:1, or genotypic ratio will be 1:2, 2:1. So remember. Now second case, when pure plant TT were crossed over the dwarf plant. So tall characters, we all know, in the under the tall and the dwarf, tall one is the dominant trait. So in the F1 generation all will be tall. So here they are showing in a Punnett square. So when we will do the hybridization and we can do the Punnett square, you can see the tall, you have to write like this, and this this dwarf one. So you all four are having the capital T and small t capital T is the dominant. So all in the F1 generation all will be tall, all the P plant will be tall, but in the F2 generation when we will cross with the heterozygous here also and here also, so we will get in the ratio of the same ratio, one will be pure tall, one will be pure dwarf, and other two are the center two are the heterozygous hybrid one. It also contain the capital T dominant trait and recessive, but dominant will super rule, so both three will be the tall because it contain the tall gene, and this last one will be the short, it contains the short gene. So the genotypic ratio will be 1:2, 2:1, always remember, and phenotypic will be 3:1. So this is the second case. Third case, when we the same thing, because you know in the mono we can take any trait, any character we can take, but in the mono hybrid ratio the genotypic and phenotypic ratio will be the same. So here they are showing the three cases and all are similar to each other, only the characters are changing. So here in the third case, the pure round seed plant and the pure wrinkled seed plant, when we will do the Punnett square, first generation we will get the all the round seeds plant because all are having the dominant character of capital R, and in the F2 generation when we will hybridized the two heterozygous gene, so we will get the same thing, we will get the purely round, purely the wrinkled, and the between this middle two they are the heterozygous. So the genotypic ratio will be 1:2, 2:1 and 3:1. So here in all the three cases the mono hybrid ratio are the same, you can take any character. Phenotypic ratio of mono hybrid will be always 3:1 and genotypic ratio will be 1:2, 2:1. Exceptions are there that you will learn in the higher classes, but for this 10th class just remember this thing only. So what is the principle, which principle it is based? So first thing, each pair of contrasting character depends on the pair of genes. So here you can see I told you how to do that hybridization, we have to pick one first character and we have to cross with the other two, and then we have to write in these one two column. The second one we have to take, then after filling the two columns of these two, we have to pick the second character, second allele, and then we have to cross with the other two and we have to write it here. So like this only we have the pair of genes. So the characters of genotypic character, phenotypic character based on the purely contrasting character or a pair of gene. Each individual carrying, and we all know that each individual, whether it is plants, whether it is animal, they contain a genes in duplets, in pairs. Next, third point is, an individual produces gamete sexes which have only one member of a pair of genes. So we know that for the sex cells, females have the XX genes and males have a XY genes. Fourth one is fertilization. Fertilization of gametes restores the duplicate conditions of the genes. So that gene is restored the sequence when it transferred. So fertilization is very important. Then only when it fertilized, then only, for example, I told you that when X will fertilize with the Y only, then only we will get the XY gamete or individual. So fertilization of the gamete restored the their information, duplicate condition of the genes in the form of genes sequence. Now the sex cells which respect to the genes, they contain and they get fertilized at random. So randomly they can based on their sequences or their situations, they can fertilized. Next is dihybrid cross. You know, die means two. So here we have to breed we have to do the hybridization, we have to take the two pairs of contrasting character. So here he has done, Mendel tried several combination based on the characters, seven we have heard in that diagram. But in this case, he has taken round and yellow seed. So the our seed is round also and yellow, first one, and the another sequence is wrinkled and green one. So here are two characters, round and yellow, wrinkled and green. Okay, one is this, one is round, seed is round also, so it is one character, and the color of the seed also, yellow and green. So here, this is the dihybrid ratio. So in this ratio, in the F1 generation, you can see shortly it is written in the blue box, that F1 generation, this round and yellow is the dominant, so all the four will be round and yellow. In the F1 generation, all will have the dominant character. But in the second generation, that which is F2, we will get all the plants in the ratio of 9:2, 3:2, 3:1. So it is complicated. 9:2, 3:2, 3:1. So dihybrid ratio in F2 generation will be 9:2, 3:2, 3:1. So remember, this is very important. So 9 is the yellow and green. Round and yellow, 3 will be the round and green, 3 will be the wrinkled and yellow out of 16, and wrinkled and green. So this is a shortly summary they have given. Now here they are showing the diagram, that you can see here round and yellow, he used capital R and capital Y. So why they have written 2R and 2Y, because we always show that gene sequence always occurs in the pairs like this. Wrinkled and green, they have used the small r and small y. So in the F1 generation, all will be round and yellow. So they have the capital R also, Y also. So it is a dominant, so it will superrule, it will suppress this gene. Now in the F2 generation, you can see when we will do the Punnett square in the class, Zoom class, I will explain you this also. So you can see when in the F2 generation, it is highly complex. So phenotypic ratio will be, phenotypic means jo hume dikhta hai, which we can see. So phenotypic ratio we can see by looking that 9 are the round and yellow, 3 are the round and green, 3 are the wrinkled and yellow, and one is the totally wrinkled, this last one, distorted shape. So by this phenotypically we can see the picture also. So phenotypic ratio of this F2 generation will be 9:2, 3:2, 3:1. Remember this. And genotypically it is very complex. So in the exam, if they will ask what is the genotypic ratio of the, so no need to learn these sequence because they are highly complex. Simply write the they are complex. So it is written also, you can see in this yellow box all the information is given. This yellow box is very important. So monotypic ratio in the F2 generation they are showing. So F2 generation phenotypic ratio will be 3:1, genotypic ratio will be 1:2, 2:1. But in the dihybrid ratio, in F2 generation, phenotypic ratio will be 9:2, 3:2, 3:1. But the genotypic ratio will be very, very complex, very complex. It is written. So in the exam also, if they will ask what is the genotypic ratio of dihybrid in the F2 generation, you will write only very complex, simply. Okay. So in the next class, I will explain you the Mendel's law of inheritance. So till now, just go through the monohybrid and dihybrid cross and try to solve this Punnett square. It is not that much complex, but try to do. Okay, and I will explain you in the Zoom class also. So please go through this. Thank you, children, and have a nice day. God bless you all.